happened to Seijiro Takeshita is the director at Mizuho International, and he joins us live now from London. Seijiro, good to see you again. Thanks for joining us.
Hi.
What message are you taking away from this volatility that we're seeing with the Nikkei?
Well, I think what we're seeing here is basically, as you just reported earlier, a lot of adjustment, which really hadn't taken place for such a long time. And quite a lot of shares, which really didn't accommodate true fundamentals of a recovery, have been rising under the name of laggard. So, of course, we do need this, I would say, cool down period, and therefore look forward to the companies that really actually would benefit from the Abenomics and also from the weakening of the yen, because the companies still have not really reaped the benefit of the weakening of the yen yet. We are likely to see that in coming two quarters.
Now, the Bank of Japan minutes from the April meeting were released today, and they actually showed some disagreement over the 2% inflation target that they've announced. And there was this argument that inflation target is contradictory with the Bank of Japan saying they want to keep interest rates low but also push inflation higher. How do you see this playing out?
Well, you know, I would say 70 or 80% of the economists out there do not believe that this 2% in 2 years could really be possible. What's really important here is that finally, Bank of Japan, or the Japanese, I would say, government, has become a lot more verbal about interventions and making numerical targets. And basically, I personally don't think that there's anybody that really thinks that this is easily done. It would be very difficult, but they have made these numerical targets showing support to do anything to reflate the economy and have the economy back on track, particularly through the capital expenditure that we're likely to see on the domestic front, which would basically start moving the cycles of the Japanese economy a lot better than before. So to really pinpoint the target of 2% itself, I think, is not really the point, although that is a target that the Bank of Japan has given out.
So, Jero, it's Charles Hodgson here in London. I declare a personal interest. I've put a lot more money into the Japanese stock market last week because I know you're very optimistic always about it, but you might be about to tell me that I've been an idiot. Because I think it seems to me, how far can we go? How much further can the Nikkei rise on the basis of what Mr. Abe stands for? Clearly, he stands for monetary expansion, for fiscal expansion, you know, $100 billion worth of public projects and all that. Also, and this is the one which I imagine is going to be the hardest to quantify, the impact of his supply side reforms. What do you feel? Do you feel that the markets are looking forward perhaps to Abenomics being rather less successful than it will in reality turn out to be? Or do you think that perhaps they've overshot, that they've been too optimistic about how much Mr. Abe as Prime Minister can achieve with that three-pronged program?
Well, I don't think that there's an excessive pessimism. There should be excessive pessimism out there. I don't think you made the right move. I think you made the right move, Charles, except that I think you have to wait a little bit longer this time around to see the polarization. In other words, the right ones, the correct ones, the real true beneficiary of Abenomics from here onwards will, I think, thrive. And if you look at, for example, the benefits of weakening yen of many of these quality companies will come through, not only from the weakening of the yen, but also from the competitiveness point of view, where they will regain market share back from the Germans and the Koreans. And on top of it, as you were saying, we'll have election on the 21st of July in the upper house, which is likely to end up in a massive victory for LDP, which means that a lot of policies will be a lot easier to be implemented. Now, there should be a lot more painful policies, but that should rejuvenate Japan. They should come up with policies that should rejuvenate Japan in the longer term basis. Now, this we have to watch with hawk's eye, because there's always a tendency that LDP gets to revert back to feeding the vested interest. We've seen this before, so this is what we must watch. But we have to look at the multiplier to the economy, and if it does work, then we still got a good rally that's coming ahead of us.
Again, I'm going to talk about it, the person of Mr. Abe, clearly very popular, and that's why you're saying that the upper house election will confirm that, the LDP, will his party, will do very well out of that. But he's also rather nationalistic, and that seems to be, if you like, the zeitgeist, the sign of the times in Japan. We can talk about that elsewhere. But does he have what it takes, not just to push through the program at the level of the legislature, at the level of the Japanese Diet and the upper house and so on, but actually to get people to change their thinking? Because it really will be tough, won't it, to reform Japanese agriculture, the Japanese pharmaceutical industry, the electrical power industry. These are really tough nuts to crack, even if you have all the right legislation in place.
Absolutely. And that's why I think that the real rejuvenation program should come after the election, when he is actually allowed to make these painful policies. Now, if he reverts back to wishy-washy, make everybody happy, but in long-term painful policies by piling up the debt, which is exactly what the Japanese government is doing the past 20 years, then no, we don't have our future. But this is where it's really most important. We really have to, again, watch very carefully whether he will implement painful, transitional, structural, painful, you know, policies to be implemented on many of the future growth areas in Japan. But for the time being, at least, we have, in short to mid-run, the Japanese exporter, who always leads the Japanese economy through capital expenditure increase, coming back to their feet. If we can witness this in the next two quarters, then, at least for the time being, for the next 2 years or so, I think we have a very good time of, I should say, rejuvenation process that would make a very good plateau for these transitional changes on structure.
Seijiro Takeshita, always great to talk to you. And certainly this story of Japan for the past 6 months has been fascinating to follow. Seijiro Takeshita from Mitsuo International.